Hi, I'm Kressel Anderson, this is Makercise. In this episode, I'll be making crucible tongs and alloying bronze from scratch.
Special thanks to Metal Supermarkets for sponsoring this episode of Makercise.
I have a number 8 crucible that I have fired before in the kiln. And now I am going to load it up with copper. While that's coming up to temperature, I am going to fabricate using a spare one that I have. I'm going to fabricate a set of tongs and a pouring shank for this crucible.
For the two handles, I'll drill a hole and then secure them together using a steel pop rivet. And I think it's important to use steel versus aluminum for this application. After I had the tongs adjusted to pretty much where I wanted them, I used a microwave transformer just to kind of test them out with some weight in the crucible.
Hey, buddy.
Hey, pal. How are you?
Did you buy the new tool?
I built a new tool.
Did you buy that?
I built this. Well, I did it. I came in just in time. Currently, the kiln's at 1977 degrees Fahrenheit, and that is right below the melting point of copper, something like 1984-ish. I fabbed up a set of tongs to pick up the crucible from inside the kiln. And then I also fabbed up a, that's still a little hot from the weld, also fabbed up a pouring shank with the little retention hook. And this should allow me to pour from the side, which is a much better posture for pouring. So I'll get the welder dragged back in, drag out my sand base, and get ready to pour some copper ingots. Pretty exciting.
It took slightly over 4 hours for the kiln to get up to the melting point of copper, and for me to fabricate the tongs and shank. It took another 45 minutes after that for the kiln to power through the latent heat of fusion and get the copper up to a pouring temperature of 2,070 degrees.
Ooh, it's crackling.
Okay. These are the first few copper ingots that I made, along with some of the materials I'll use for alloying bronze.
This video is sponsored by Metal Supermarkets. They're the convenience stores for metal, and they source hot and cold rolled steel, aluminum, stainless, and more from over 80 locations across North America. For maker-sized projects like these crucible tongs or the lathe cart, Metal Supermarkets is a great place to get materials because they focus on small quantities. Support companies that support Makercise. Use the link below to request a quote today for your next project. The voltage on the system, probably because it's getting to be summer, lower. It's not 120 volts, it's 116 volts. That means my kiln is kind of flatlined. It's not getting any hotter. It's at about 1960, 1980 degrees. I think there's molten copper in there, but it doesn't look like it's going to get any hotter. So I'm going to try putting it down in my little portable foundry and see how that works. So I alloyed up some lead, tin, and zinc. In proportions that should give me alloy 932 bronze. So these are the amounts that I use for lead, tin, and zinc. And then I made some copper ingots, as well as some little copper drippings into a water bucket. So that way I can, you know, get kind of a precise amount. We'll find out how accurate this comes out. So now I need to figure out how much copper I need. So this is 150 grams, and that should be 17% of whatever this ingot comes to. So I take 150 divided by 0.17, and that gives me 882 grams for this ingot, which means when I multiply that times the remaining 83%, I get 732 grams. So 732 grams of copper. I'll go ahead and add in all the copper, but I'm going to save the tin, zinc, lead ingot for after all the copper is molten. I'll drop it in there right before I pour.
So this would imply we're not ready at all.
This would imply we're very close to being ready. It's known as zinc vapor. Try not to breathe that.
That's really hot.
What's that?
That's really hot.
It is really hot. This is the bronze ingot that I cast. It's kind of got a cool color, but it also looks a little bit stratified, kind of like rock where you've got different layers. So I'm hoping that's not where the zinc, the lead, or the tin has kind of caused different layering. But I guess we'll take a look here, do some scratching and filing, and see what it looks like here inside. I've got this assortment of various grits from about 400 up to 3,000. This is wet dry sandpaper silicon carbide. I got it off Amazon. I'll have a link down in the description, but I'm going to try to take this surface up to a pretty good polish and see how thorough the alloying, how consistently it looks throughout this ingot. I should have checked to see what my yield was before I polished off that corner, but I'm pretty sure it was close to 850, when I weighed it, pretty close to 850, so it should be slightly less than that. Obviously, the material that I took out in the saw kerf should improve the yield. Yeah, so I think there's about 8 grams missing from that saw kerf, but let's call it 850. 850 out of our 882 grams going into it, a yield of 96% during the alloying with the tin, zinc, lead ingots, and the copper. So the next step is for us to check out how closely I got to my target of 932 bronze.
This analysis is from an X-ray fluorescence analyzer. I thought it was really neat that the analyzer identified the ingot as C932 bronze. These are portable handheld devices that can tell you the elemental composition of items such as ingots. It's really cool technology, but it's also really pricey.
Thanks to everybody who's supporting me on Patreon. I really appreciate it. And I hope this video builds your confidence to exercise your inner maker. Thanks for watching.